the voice instructor, thank you for turning it off. In November, when I started gathering music for this concert, the song Love in Any Language, a song by Sandy Patty from 1984, kept running through my head. Now, I wasn't even considering performing a choral arrangement of this song, but every piece of music that I selected or even considered seemed to be a love song. Also, when selecting music, I noticed my trend to select music in a variety of languages. As any one of the chamber or community chorus members may attest, I like performing music in different languages. So when I finalized all the music and decided on a theme for the concert, it was natural that the Sandy Patty Love in Any Language present itself again. But as one of the chamber chorus singers pointed out about 2 weeks ago, some of our selections are not only about love, but also praise and adoration. In other words, it gave me an opportunity to modify Sandy Patty's song title from Love in Any Language to the theme for our concert this evening, Loved and Adored in Many Languages. The first selection that the chamber chorus will sing tonight falls under the genre of chance music. Chance music is music that is created with one or more elements at random, or left up to chance, like the roll of the dice or the flip of a coin. The composer, Ross Whitney, has specified each pitch and some dynamics. There are several music elements missing from this composition that each performer will complete. For example, there are no tempo markings, and the composer has even written that each line is to move ad lib independently, fast, moderate, slow. There are some dynamic markings, but we take liberties with dynamics, our louds and softs. There are 7 vocal lines in this piece. 5 of the 7 have only 5 different pitches, thus creating a pentatonic or 5-tone sound. The text of the piece is simply the word Alleluia. What better way to begin a concert titled Loved and Adored in Many Languages than with the single Hebrew word Alleluia?
Thank you.
Na and Dinta. In the past, one might have referred to these syllables as nonsense syllables. Today, it is more common to call syllables such as these vocables, a term, a word composed of various sounds without regard to its meaning. For what may be nonsense to my ears may denote or mean something to another person and is not nonsense at all. Dravidian dithira combined elements of Indian ragas and talas. This song features Dr. Josh Martin on piano.
Thank you.
his confrontation with Ahab and Jezebel, his flight to the wilderness and encounter with the Lord, and his journey to Mount Horeb and ascension to heaven in flaming chariot. Wow, that beats reality TV any day. Lift Thine Eyes, Movement 28 from the Oratorio, is affectionately called the Angel Trio. Elijah has just fallen asleep beneath a juniper tree, and the angels of the Lord encircle him to sing.
Thank you. Oh, Lord, teach and give.
opportunity to invite you to sing with the community chorus next fall. Yes, you can sing in the community chorus. It's easy. All you have to do is learn 20 new languages and a lot of notes. It's not that hard. Ask any one of them. Is it that hard?
No.
Are you shaking your head yet? Come on. All right. Our final selection is Bolseyaba. It is sung in the language Chimbema, which is spoken mainly in Zambia. It is a Christian song of celebration. I welcome to the stage Eric Utter, who is on a modified djembe. Where are you, Eric? Come on out. Thanks. And to the front of the stage, I welcome Daniel Kern, our tenor soloist. Thank you for coming again. We hope you felt loved and adored in many languages.
Bonseyaba, pokele la malipeli maka, uba bana. Bonseyaba, pokele la malipeli maka.